أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
For the people of Kuwait, Baghdad's back down and America's stand down hold little promise of a new day dawning.
We have averted a crisis rather than solving it. As long as that regime stays in power, then there is no end in sight. As simple as that.
Kuwait is a country where oil's black gold is transformed to the real gold of wealth and privilege. And yet, men still harvest and barter the bounty of the Persian Gulf, as they have since before history was written. And as they once did in Bedouin tents, gather for the Diwaniya in the cool of the desert evening. It means the time to talk. And on this night, the talk is about the man they call the evil to the north.
We simply have to live at the edge of fear, maybe.
Physics professor Mustafa Marafi is a realist who sees the limits of even America's superpower.
Even in Panama, which is a small country, it took lots of time and effort, money, and maybe human lives in order to get rid of a dictator. So there is no way that any superpower or any minor power can go inside militarily and occupy the country.
Hamza Taki is an American educated banker who thinks Saddam will never give up his desire to take Kuwait.
He has interest in Kuwait, you know, and he is educating even in the school the children that Iraq is, that Kuwait is belong to Iraq, you know, and in their mind this is what he is brainwashing them.
This is Kuwait's Al Jaber Air Force Base, and behind me, America's first line of offense, the F-117 stealth fighter. But even here, amid the dedication of American soldiers, they ask the question, how much longer is this going on?
I've been over Iraq 5 times now.
Lieutenant Colonel Dick Rayburn is an F-16 pilot based in South Dakota.
We all need to look at what has happened in the past. And I think that, you know, as we look out into the future, that we're probably going to be have a presence here for quite a while.
All right, go ahead, move to your left.
And the ongoing threat is taking its toll on those we ask to keep coming here, like Cavalry Scout Sergeant Major Matthew Parker.
What I don't understand is why we continue to allow the UN to bring us over here, send us home, bring us over here and send us home and not finish the job.
Can Kuwait ever live in peace as long as Saddam Hussein is alive?
You will have a unanimous and very strong no for that question.
Political scientist Abdullah Al-Shaeji worries about the questions that still plague the Arab world. He sees in the street demonstrations against bombing and the lack of support among Arab leaders for America's stand against Iraq this time that Arabs wonder, why can Israel harbor dangerous weapons without facing the punishment America is targeting at Iraq?
If today is Iraq, then tomorrow probably it's going to be Syria, and the day after it's going to be Iran. And then what's going to be left is that Israel with its nuclear arsenal and its chemical, biological warfare that could dictate its terms on the Arabs in the peace process. So there is a link here between the peace process on one hand and the Gulf policy of the United States on the other hand.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I just finished briefing the Security Council.
He watched carefully as Kofi Annan celebrated his diplomatic victory with Saddam.
I think I can do business with him. I think he was serious when he took the engagement.
And the professor remembers another trip by then Senator Bob Dole in early 1990, before Iraq invaded Kuwait.
He went back to report to President Bush after that visit. And guess what he told President Bush? He told him the same line. We met with Saddam Hussein, and we can do business with this man. And guess what? 4 months later, he was devouring Kuwait. So I hope history will not repeat itself, but I'm afraid it will.
This last week, they celebrated that day 7 years ago when Allied forces liberated Kuwait. But how much longer must America and its allies stay? How much longer will Saddam Hussein's shadow stretch across Kuwait's future? Ah, said the Kuwaitis, the Middle East teaches patience. Here, we measure time not in days or weeks, but in years.